be paying every day, I think it will make the government to sit up. In Zamfara, just yesterday, about 14 people, this thing. If you charge the government to be paying 50 million for each zone, I think the government will wake up. We can't continue. Our people are being killed every day. They are being buried like garbage. Why are we so in a hurry to even bury those people? Within 48 hours, you cannot even allow people to come and identify their loved ones and go and bury them. You put them like nothing. You look up in Lagos, a tanker exploded. You look at the people in the hospital, they are there, left on their own. So what is the value? We must ask ourselves, what is the value of human life in Nigeria? And every day, we keep seeing headsmen, Fulani, everything they call it. Arrest the people. We are all, the work of the security is not even mobilizing. It's to prevent these things. It's not about telling us that after crisis, you have mobilized or something. It's not the work. So we are here every day, we bring motion, we bring things. It is time, everything is on top of the president table. A lot of things are going on and he has to take action. If he doesn't take action, this thing will continue to take place. This thing is something that we can solve. We have people that can solve this problem. But because of hypocrisy, because they don't have godfathers, they are being relegated to nothing. Today you see the police are demoralized, not disciplined in the police, because you create a special promotion that you keep promoting people that are giving money, people that are close to politicians, people that are close to you. You can imagine the spokesperson of the Nigerian police. Three months ago, he was CSP. Under some days, they gave him special promotion as assistant commissioner of police. After a month, they gave him a special promotion to deputy commissioner of police. Today, commissioner of police, what can he do? What can he do? Whereby some people are there in Maiduguri fighting Boko Haram, fighting so many things. Even their allowances are not paid. Somebody is sitting in the office every month. You are giving him special promotion. Giving money. Without the police, we cannot achieve anything. No country will progress under democracy without the police. And there is no discipline there. The morale of the officers totally down. There was an officer that called me. He said because of that special promotion, he felt like joining Boko Haram. He said that is what he felt. And another police officer that met Senator. That's another policeman that met Senator Na'ala. What you told Na'ala, you can confide on Na'ala because of this injustice that is taking place. If we are accusing the former government of corruption, then we are doing worse than in injustice. A lot of injustice is taking place in the country, and we are not addressing it, and we are thinking that we will have positive results. It's not possible. We are not the only country that God that have God. Every other country, they are praying to God. Other country, every other person, they have God. We should do the right thing. We can't be blaming God. This will happen. We say, God. Prayer will not solve the problem, but we have to do the right thing. If we don't do the right thing, we'll continue. Unless we don't care with our people. You can hear the narratives of the DSP when he was talking about American citizens. If one American dies, either in one front or anywhere, they will spend anything to go and get their body. They can spend anything. They can protect it anywhere. He doesn't have to be in that country. Any country, they will move there to protect their person. Do we do it? Instead, even the people that are doing the right thing, we want to eliminate them. We want to fill their mouths. Which kind of country is this? We have to do the right thing. If not, I see no reason why we continue to be talking about democracy when there is no democracy. The democracy is about respect to the rule of law, the constitution. Do we do it? Do we respect the constitution? Do we respect the rule of law? Do we do it? So which one are we practicing? Why are we sitting here? Is it that all of us, we don't have work to do apart from this? we should try and form any kind of government that want to, but the democracy is not working. It's not working. If this is democracy, then it's a sham. This is not democracy. Democracy is something that at least the people will be protected. People are not protected now. Mr. President, I just have to just sit down. It's not about a passing resolution. It's about acting on those resolutions. The people surrounding the president should not look at the National Assembly. Even if they don't want us, let them look at what we are saying. Let them implement the good thing. You can decide to say you don't like me. No problem, don't like me. But the thing, if what I'm saying makes sense, do it. Do it. And this is the result of what is happening. This is the result. Because of few individuals, we have compromised democracy, we have compromised our security, we have compromised everything. And a lot of people now, the same thing that happened during Goodluck's regime, when people make statements to say, do this, they will say it's enemy. Anybody now giving his own advice to the government, before you know, they say you are an enemy to the government. Is democracy not a government that people will advise? Because it's a representative government. It's government represented by everybody. We have every right when we sit in. And when you are there, it's just like football. If you are inside, you will not see the mistake. But somebody that is outside will see the mistake. And that is the time maybe he will provide solution for you. So they are there. They will not see the mistake. Is it everybody that will get to the villa? Or is it everybody that will get to the executive to tell them? So it's for us to do the right thing. This thing that we are doing in the National Assembly that cannot solve the problem. 18 months ago, I said the killing will continue. And if they don't act, the killing will continue. It's bad. It's very bad. We are not safe. If you think that maybe you are moving with a sarin, you are moving with a policeman, if they block it, you will be surprised. The security men that they are protecting you, they will be the first people to run and leave you. They will be the first to leave you. So we are not safe. We should try.